Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, I'm going to show you how to use multiple microphones simultaneously in GarageBand. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So say you want to use multiple microphones at the same time in GarageBand, so each microphone goes into its own track. You can set that up using the audio MIDI utility that comes with your Mac and knowing how to set it up in GarageBand. So the first thing you need to do is build what's called an aggregate device that's going to be a single input device that includes the channels from all of your microphones. So to do that, you're going to run an app called Audio MIDI Setup. It comes with your Mac. If you just use Go to Utilities, you go to your Utilities folder inside your Applications folder and you'll find it there. Or you can just search for it in Spotlight. Now here you're going to see every audio input and output device. So here's one microphone and it says two inputs. Here's another microphone and this has got one input and it's got two outputs, because a lot of times microphones include speakers or listening devices, or if it's like a headset like this, of course, there are outputs. And then here's another one, the main mic that I used, and there's a set of two outputs and two inputs here. This also has a headphone jack for you to monitor. That's why there's two outputs. So you want to use the plus button here and create an aggregate device. And then you get to name this device. So I'm going to name it All Mics. And I'm going to add here in this list all of the mics I want to include. So I only want to look at things that have inputs. Here's one microphone, so I'll add that. Let's go in the list here and look for this microphone here. I'll add that, and then here's the other one, and I'll add that. So now you can see I have five channels. One of the microphones only has a single channel, the other two are stereo. Now I get to choose which one is the clock source, which basically means which one's running the show here. So it probably doesn't matter, but I'll choose this one here. I could choose my sample rate if that's important to me. I can see all of the different devices here and which channel they map to. And notice that drift correction is checked off for the ones that are not set as the clock source. In other words, it's going to try to adjust the timing so everything's in sync. So now I'm all set here. So now in GarageBand, I'm going to start an empty project and I'm going to start off with one audio track using a microphone. And you can see here I can choose the instrument. So I'm going to click that and that will open up GarageBand preferences and allow me to choose the input device. I'm going to go from system setting to all mics, which is the aggregate device that I created. Now with all mics selected, I can click here and I could see the different inputs. You can see there are five different inputs here. Now I know that the first two, one and two, are the left and right stereo inputs from one microphone. So I'll select those. I'll hit create and I get a track here that's going to listen in on that microphone. I'm going to hit the plus button to create a new track and also choose that as audio, but this time I'm going to do 3 and 4, so the second microphone. And then I'm going to do the plus button again and choose 5. I could choose 5 and 6, but there is no track 6. 5 to get that last microphone that's only one track. So now I have 3 different microphones, but the problem is only one's recording at a time. So if I click this one, you could see that it's picking up my voice there, but these other two go silent. If I select this one, it's picking up my voice there, but these two are silent. So it's only going to record one at a time. You can change that by selecting a track, and if you control click on it, you can do configure track header, and you see it's option T is the keyboard shortcut for that. And I can put record enable on for that track. And I'll make sure record enable is on for each of these tracks. Now that record enable is on, I can click record for each one of these. So all 3 now are flashing red and they're going to record from each one of these microphones. So now when I talk, you can see each one's recording and some of them are picking up better because they're right in front of my mouth. Others are off to the side and I get 3 tracks. Now when I play it back, I can hear all 3. So now when I talk, you can see each one's recording. Now how well this works definitely depends on the quality of the mics. When I tried it with some older cheap microphones, it gave a noticeable echo. So even with drift correction, the timing was a little bit off. But with the 3 mics I was using, which were all pretty good, there was no noticeable echo. So it would have worked, say, if I had three people around a table, each with their own microphone recording a podcast. Or three people playing different instruments, each being hooked up as a different audio input. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.